Drag means to challenge gender and gender roles and dressing up and having fun and having a good time and playing around with the rules. I normally go under the name Brynhildr. In drag, I am called Brynhildr the ViQueen. Brynhildr the ViQueen is a large and in charge person. She is dressing up as a superheroine, superwoman, Wonder Woman. There she was. Yeah, exactly like Wonder Woman. Legally, I'm called Rasmus, but I mostly go under the name Brynhildr, which is the performer name that I chose for myself. To me, being non-binary means that I live outside of the gender binary.
I just take off most of my eyebrows before I do makeup because then I don't need to glue them down.
It means that I just am not a man nor a woman. I see myself that way and I just live as a very effeminate person that lives every day how I just want it to be.
Brynhildr is 24 years old. She has been doing drag for 4 years.
It's my all-time favorite show, and also the dress I had on, it's just a big girl and a big babe take up space. Yeah, I love it.
I went to like this acting studio to become a trained actor, but they didn't really accept or like that I was feminine. So I just started doing drag instead because I found this creative direction where I could put the rules and I had to make like, I could make and choose what I wanted to do. Drag is often a calling more than it's you sit down and say, now I want to be a drag queen. It's more like it just is a calling to like dress up and be extravagant and do that thing that people like, you cannot wear women's clothing. Oh honey, I can.
No need to fantasize.
For every performance, a drag queen needs the perfect costume. Brynhildr keeps her outfits down at her basement. Due to the corona outbreak, most drag shows are cancelled. But Brynhildr agreed to do us a little private show later today. Right now, we're at Brynhildr's walk-in closet, where she has a lot of glamorous costumes. And now, she's actually choosing her costume for our tonight's little private show.
So I have this one. I'm already in drag. I'm so quick. I love it. Anyway, here's a dress. This is like the big chaotic dress from, ooh, what's that? From that Big Girls, You're Beautiful. It doesn't look like much, but like, fat.
After choosing her costume, it normally takes Brynhildr 2 hours to drag up.
We need to build a new face on top of our own. I want all these male features to go away and be more soft and be more like, delicate. I see myself more belonging to the female side of the world, but it's difficult to explain. Because I still have this big beard, and often it's like, that's a masculine trait, but to me it's like one of the things that makes me more like a woman.
But challenging the social norms doesn't always come easy.
I've been, through a few things because I am dressed how I like to be. I've been beat up where I have to go to the hospital multiple times, and I've woken up in my bed one time where I was unable to move because someone had beaten me up the night before. But I don't want the hateful energies to win over me and let that define who I am and how I live. I want myself to define how I live.
Despite all of the hardships, Brynhildr will keep on doing what she loves most.
Right now, we are on our way to the Maskin Bar to see Brynhildr's mini private show for us.
Look into the room, feels like a big balloon. I said, hey, girls.
I want to be 65 years old with a glass of wine in my hand on stage and being like, I've been doing this for 50 years. Hit it, DJ! To be an old hag who have seen the war and just be like, I fought for this future. I want that to happen.
beautiful.